In this video we will learn how to set up the Combat Zone tab in the Adrenaline Bot interface. The settings of this tab determine the area in which our bot will look for new targets during farming. The adjustment of what targets our bot should look for is done in the Target Search tab. And we have a separate video dedicated to this. A link to the playlist will be at the end of this video. Combat Zone Settings. Here you need to choose one of the six possible types of zones. Let's take a closer look at them. Arbitrarily. If you select this option, the bot will simply search for nearby targets without being tied to any zone at all. This can be useful if you want to quickly test a spot. We do not recommend using this option for full-fledged farming, because the bot is not limited by anything and can easily go to nearby location unless you set restrictions on the names and levels of targets. Center of Combat Zone. When this option is selected, every time you turn on the farm in the Adrenaline Bot, it will remember the current position of the character and make it the center of a circle or square zone with specified radius. You can set up the shape of the zone and the radius next to this option. Center and Point. Is almost the same as the previous option, though the coordinates of the point are now indicated explicitly. Your current coordinates can be filled in automatically via button. The zone shape and radius are adjusted in the same way as in previous option. Multi-corner zone. By selecting this type of zone, you can set up a free-form area in the table that appears below. You need to specify several points here. Let's consider a simple configuration option using the example of catacombs with rectangular rooms. We come to the room that we want to farm, put the character in the first corner. Click the current button, the current coordinates of the character will appear in the X, Y, Z fields. Then click the add button, and do the same thing with each corner one by one. Thus, you can build any geometric shape you want. Move using path. This method involves a simple list of zones with centers and radius. The bot will move from zone to zone and kill mobs. The zones are configured in the same table, though now you need to adjust the radius. The shape of the zone is also configurable. Circle or square. Please note that the bot will not understand if there are obstacles along the way or not, so this option will work well in open locations, but the problems may arise in, for example, catacombs. However, you can add zones with zero radius, and they will serve as checkpoints through which the bot will move to normal zones, rather than trying to run towards them directly through walls. Also, keep in mind that the bot will move through the list of zones from top to bottom, and then from bottom to top. If you want to set up farming on several difficult zones, try the Hunter plugin. It allows you to change spots according to different conditions and move between them along pre-drawn routes. Map is the most advanced and frequently used type of zone in the Adrenaline Bot. Maps are drawn in the main Adrenaline Bot window in the map section, and with their help, you can create difficult zones with obstacles. Obstacles are zones that the bot will avoid and won't attack the mobs inside them. Zones are stored in separate files with the .z map extension in the settings folder. You can share ready-made zones with your friends. By default, the bot uses the zone currently opened in the bot, but you can configure the auto-loading of a specific zone for a specific bot config, so as not to open it manually every time. To do this, click on the ellipsis button and select the desired zone from the settings folder. If you see a blue screen instead of a map, make sure to download the maps via updater and enable the map display in the bot. Calculate map distance. By default, the bot searches for the nearest target simply by comparing the distance between the character and the potential target. But sometimes such closest target may be behind the wall or any other obstacle, and, in fact, is not the most suitable target. If this option is enabled, the bot will create a path to each target on the map and look for the nearest target according to the zone you have drawn. This slightly increases the processor load, so if you have a lot of bots running and the bot starts to lag a bit, try either disable this option or simplify the zone as much as possible, for example, by reducing the number of points or red zones. Avoid obstacles. If a bot stumbles upon an obstacle, e.g. a tree, while moving, it will try to avoid it according to these settings. This option works as follows: if the bot ran into an obstacle and got stuck, it will take a few steps back first, then to the side, and then again will try to go to the destination. Timeout start. The time, in milliseconds, after which the bot will start trying to run around the obstacle. Back. The time range in which the bot will take several steps back. to side. The time range in which the bot will take several steps to the side. Z limit. This option enables or disables checking the difference in height between the target and your bot, or the starting point of the battle. Targets above or below the limit you specified will be ignored. This setting is relevant if farming takes place in multi-level location, such as Forge of the Gods, or on mountainous terrain like the Partisan's Hideaway. Don't attack out of combat zone, attack after specified number of seconds. When this option is activated, the bot will not fight off mobs outside the combat zone. If a mob runs out of the zone during the battle, the bot will stop attacking it, return to the starting point of battle, and will start looking for new targets. In such case, the bot will ignore the mob for the specified number of seconds, so that it can return to the farming zone. Back to combat zone center if no target. This checkbox works as follows: if the bot cannot find a new target within the specified number of seconds, it returns to the center of configured zone and will search for new targets again. For the map type of zone, the center is the point at which the bot was activated. Now you know everything about setting up a combat zone in the Adrenaline Bot interface. If you want to know about the settings of other tabs, watch the video on our channel. And also subscribe and learn more about the capabilities of the Adrenaline Bot and scripts for it. You can buy a bot on our official website adrenalinebot.com. If you have any questions, feel free to contact our technical support in Discord.